Hey everyone, welcome back to another Species Spotlight. I'm Miss Nicole here in the garden, and today we're highlighting the, your guess is as, what do you think it is? Let's look up. Oh, it's coconut palm. Now, oddly enough, coconut palm technically isn't really native here, but its true origin is unknown because these seeds have been spread primarily by humans. I'll get into more of that later. But what we do know is that they are surviving in the tropical area. So anywhere tropical, you can find coconut palm. So coconut palm has this really thick, nice bark, and it goes from its roots all the way up to the coconuts and the leaves. And the leaves are actually a feather-like, so they look like a giant feather. And the leaves can be 18 feet long by 4 feet wide. And they come out of a singular stem and expand, so that's called pinnate. These trunks can also get to be 100 feet tall. So imagine this tree 100 feet up with leaves and coconuts. These also produce small flowers, and there are male and female plants. So here we have a couple different coconut palms in the area. And the flowers they produce are small, yellow, and white. They have coconuts, as we know, are delicious, right? So the coconut is actually the seed, which most people didn't know. And as I mentioned, the coconuts have primarily been spread by humans, but they can be spread naturally. And they can be spread by dropping into the water, and they float in the ocean, and they can float up for months until they finally land somewhere. The coconut opens, you've got the seed, and that's how it'll grow naturally in the world. But inside the coconuts, we know that there's that delicious coconut milk, and there's also that fleshy skin inside the coconut, which can be used for so many different things: cooking, cleaning, cleansing. It's great for your skin, hair, and nails. And what's also interesting is that because they aren't quite sure about the native range and their origin, but we do know that they can only go to a minimum average of 72 degrees. So anything colder than that up north, not gonna happen. It's not gonna grow properly. It'll just get too cold for these coconuts. It also takes about 4 to 6 years for a coconut palm tree to mature, and then it takes 15 to 20 years for it to reach its full potential. Once it's at full potential, it can produce about 50 to 200 coconuts a year. And if you're wondering, when is the best time to drink and eat a coconut? It would be when it's about 7 months ripe. So here we have an unripe coconut. We can tell because it's green, just like the ones up there. They're not ready to come off yet. But when you find one like this, that's nice and brown, and the shell's kind of hard, not so fleshy anymore, that's how we know it's ripe. Hope you learned a lot about this species spotlight. I'm sure you'll see some coconut palms around town.